rapid decay will be a whole lot heavier than 2029. It will, however, come extraordinarily close to the Earth. So if anybody wants to travel to Brazil, you can see it fly by with their naked eyes overhead. In 2029, one of the compliments. All right, so I have covered a lot of stuff, and I think I'll finish up here and I'll switch over to questions. Thank you again.
Let me argue, just start posting it back. If you had an asteroid that was uniform, and like, you know, surface reflection, and, you know, perfectly spherical, wouldn't the effect of light from the sun's libido add energy to the asteroid's orbit without necessarily giving it more spin, so that it would actually get into an elliptical orbit over time?
So there's actually a couple of effects to this. Direct radiation pressure from the sun, sunlight coming in, that itself carries momentum. But there's the Yerkowski effects of thermal radiation going back out.
And I actually meant to tell it to say the asteroid wasn't spinning. So if it was spherical and not spinning and uniform,
if it was completely magically still and not spinning, then you just have solar radiation pressure and that causes change the eccentricity of the orbit.
Right.
So it's the Yerkowski acceleration. But the main effect of Yerkowski in the short term is to change the ascending major axis.
Yeah, although even in an asteroid that's spinning, some of the light is instantly reflecting.
And we have to correct the bulk. Reflect the sunlight and re-radiate heat.
Every year we seem to go through a cloud of meteorites. Why isn't that just sucked into the gravity of the sun? Why does it sit out there?
So, if something's in orbit around the sun, absent some other force changing that orbit, it will stay not on that orbit. So, if we have something like Phason, which is occasionally spewing out dust particles that become meteors, they stay on nearly the same orbit. They tend to spread out a little bit because of things like radiation pressure. And typically the first effect is to spread them out along the orbit, so we get a long string of dust particles sharing the orbit of Phaethon, or whichever other comet or asteroid. And that forms a ring around the orbit, and then the Earth can run through that cloud. They also spread them around the orbit, so that it may be hundreds of thousands, millions of million kilometers wide, and the Earth runs through them over the course of a day, and we see those flashes for however many hours.
So it is a
yes. And unless the electricity changes, then the sun is too close to the vaporizer.
Yeah, so late last year, there was this cigar-shaped near-Earth asteroid that got a lot of publicity through NASA, etc., on the news. And I was just curious if you could comment on that, if you knew what I was referring to, and if anybody else knows.
Is the object Oumuamua?
If anybody.
Okay, so Oumuamua is not actually a near-Earth asteroid. It passed near the Earth, but Oumuamua is something far stranger. It's an interstellar asteroid. So this came into our solar system from the outside. We haven't actually seen that happen before. We've seen asteroids and comets get kicked out of our solar system. Their eccentricity takes them up to the orbit of Jupiter. They fly by Jupiter, they can get just enough energy, they fly out of the solar system and keep on going, like the Voyager spacecraft and New Horizons have done. And they never come back. We expected that should happen around other stars, giant planets, particularly double stars, as you can do this more efficiently, maybe. We had never seen one before. Oumuamua was discovered, actually, after maybe its closest approach to the Earth, and it was on its way back out. But it became clear it was traveling very, very, very fast, so fast that it could never have been gravitationally bound to the sun in the first place. So that was very new and exciting. SETI actually has a talk about that, which is on the SETI YouTube channel. Several of the experts on the discovery and the dynamics of those objects talked about it.
The question is,
near-Earth asteroids or bringing pieces of asteroids